Okay, so we'll start with first example. In first example, I have to solve. I'll be solving it using Cauchy method. I've been given a differential equation, x squared d squared, where d is d by dx. So x squared d squared minus xt plus 1 operating on y equals to x log x. So to solve this Cauchy form of differential equation, as we have discussed, we'll be putting d equals to d by dx. So x dy by dx is nothing but x dy by dx is x dy by dx, and x squared d to y by dx squared is nothing but x squared d squared y. Now what we have to do, we'll be putting log x equals to z, so x would be e raised to z. Accordingly, dy by dz would be d1y, and or x dy would be d x dy, that is dy by dz would be d1y, and x squared d squared y would be nothing but d1 into d1 minus 1. Therefore, our differential equations would get changed. It would become d1 into d1 minus 1 by minus d1y plus y equals to e raised to z times z. So if I simplify it, I'll have d1 squared plus 2d1 plus 1 operating on y equals to e raised to z into z, which would give me auxiliary equation as d1 squared minus 2d1 plus 1 equals to 0. So this auxiliary equation has repeated roots. Those are minus 1 and 1. So my complementary function here would be c1 plus c2z e raised to z. In place of z, I'll back substitute log x. I'll have c1 plus c2 log x into e raised to log x, x my complementary function. But e raised to log x is nothing but x. So I'll have c1 plus c2 log x into x as my CF. Now to find particular integral, I'll divide by whatever left hand side I'm having. It is 1 upon d1 squared minus 2d1 plus 1 would operate on my right hand side, that is e raised to, this is my right hand side, that is e raised to z into z. So I'll have here, apply a property here, that my property of 1 upon f of d operating on e raised to x into v form. I'll have e raised to x or e raised to z we are having here. So e raised to z taken out, and in place of f of d, I'll replace it by f of d plus a. So here a is 1. So it would be d 1 upon d1 plus 1 square minus 2 into d1 plus 1 plus 1 operating on z. So it would come out to be 1 upon d1 square operating on z. So 1 upon d1 square is nothing but twice integral of into e raised to z. So e raised to z taken out, and have twice integral of z dz. So that would be z cubed by 3. So my result becomes e raised to z into z cubed by 3. I'll replace z by log x and e raised to z by x. So I'll have x log x by the whole x log x bracket cube by 6 as my answer. Equation 1 and 2 gives combined will give me general solution. My general solution y is complementary function plus particular integral, that is c1 plus c2 log x into x plus x log x plus 6. Now consider the differential equation x plus 3 whole square d to y by dx square minus 4 into x plus 3 dy by dx plus 6y equals to x. This differential equation is in the form of Legendre because I have ax plus b power multiplied by dy by dx. So this is in the form of Legendre. So here my substitution would be log of x plus 3 equals to z. So accordingly, I'll have e raised to z equals to x plus 3 or x equals to e raised to z minus 3. Since it is in the form of ax plus b squared d to y by dx squared would be a squared d into d minus 1 operating on y, and ax plus b dy by dx would be nothing but dy. So let's substitute and write d is d by dz, and a here is 1 and b here is 1. So accordingly, we'll substitute both the factors, that is a x plus 3 squared d2y by dx squared would become d into d minus 1 y. And okay, so accordingly, I'll be having d square minus d minus 4d plus 6 operating on y. And my right hand side was nothing but x, so it becomes e raised to z minus. So that is d square minus 5d plus 6 operating on y e raised to z minus 3 e raised to 0. So my complementary function here, as d value are 2 and 3. So my complementary function here is c1 e raised to 3z plus c2 e raised to 2z. I'll replace my z with log of x plus 3. So accordingly, I'll be having c1 into x plus 3 cube plus c2 into x plus 3 square as my cf. For pi, what I have to do is operate 1 upon f of d on right hand side. So my f of d here is 1 upon d square minus 5d plus 6. It would be operated on right hand side, that is e raised to z minus 3 e raised to 0. So I'll operate it separately, and I'll have 1 by 2 e raised to z minus 3 by 6 e raised to 0 z. How is it possible? So I'll compare coefficient of e raised to, so 1 upon f of d operating on e raised to az is 1 upon a e raised to az if f of d is not equals to 0. F of a is not equals to 0, sorry. F of a is here, a is 1. So f of a is 1 square minus 5a plus 6. So that is 1 plus 6, that is 7 minus 5, so 2. So it is not 0. So 1 by f of a into e raised to z would be my 1 upon d square minus 5d plus 6 operating on e raised to z. I'll have 1 by 2 e raised to z. And next, 3 minus 3 upon d square minus 5d plus 6 operating on e raised to 0 z. Again, a is 0 here. I'll have minus 3 by 6, that is minus 1 by 2 e raised to 0 z. I can take 1 by 2 common, so half. X plus 3 would half of x plus 3 minus half is would be my answer. Simplifying gives me x plus 2 plus x by 2 plus 1. So my pi would be x by 2 plus 1, and general solution would be cf plus pi, that is c1 x plus 3 cube plus c2 x plus 3 square plus x by 2 plus 1. Now we'll try to solve an example using variation of parameters. Say I have a differential equation d2y by dx squared minus 6dy by dx plus 9y equals to e raised to 3x upon x squared. Now if I take d by dx as d, my differential equation becomes d squared minus 6d plus 9 operating on y equals to e raised to 3x into x raised to minus 2. Auxiliary equation can be found by putting right hand side at 0. So I have d square minus 6d plus 9 equals to 0 as my auxiliary equation. So it has real roots d equals to 3 comma 3. These are real and repeated roots. So my complementary function accordingly would be c1 plus c2x e raised to 3x. To find particular integral using variation of parameters, what we do, we write pi as uy1 plus vy2. Our pi would be in the form always of uy1 plus vy2. For this, y1 are taken from RCF. So y1 is e raised to 3x, and y2 is taken again from CF. So y2 is x e raised to 3x. So whatever CF we have, accordingly we'll have values of y1 and y2. So y1 and y2 are known, and u and v are unknown. So to find u and v, we first find Wronskianian W. This Wronskianian W is given by determinant of y1, y2, y1 dash, y2 dash. And if it is a third order differential equation, accordingly we'll be having Wronskianian as something like this. That is determinant of y1, y2, y3, y1 dash, y2 dash, y3 dash, y1 double dash, y2 double dash, and y3 double dash. And our right hand side of differential equation, whatever it is, it is always taken as some capital X. So this capital X is, as you can see, is used in values to find values of U and V. So as we have discussed, our Wronskianian here would be determinant of e raised to 3x, x e raised to 3x. Derivative of e raised to 3x, that is 3 e raised to 3x, and derivative of x e raised to 3x, that is 3x e raised to 3x plus e raised to 6. That is, if you cross multiply and find determinant, you have e raised to 6x as a Wronskianian. So accordingly, u would be integral minus y2 into e raised to 3x, x raised to minus 2 upon Wronskianian. When substituted, we'll have integral of minus x raised to minus 1 upon 1, that is minus log x as our value of u. Similarly, we'll have value of v. V is integral v1 e raised to 3x, x raised to minus 2 upon Wronskianian. Our right hand side is e raised to 3x, x raised to minus 2. So substitution would give us x raised to minus 1 upon minus 1 as value of v. That is, value of v is minus 1 by h. So accordingly, our PI would be minus log x e raised to 3x minus 1 by x into x e raised to 3x. So it would be minus 3x log x plus 1 minus e raised to 3x log x plus 1. Our general solution would be CF plus PI. So CF was C1 e raised to 3x plus C2 x e raised to 3x plus PI. PI here is minus e raised to 3x log of x plus 1. So substituted accordingly would give us general solution.